Welcome to Onivia, League of Legends Highlights. These are the best highlights from today's LPL matchup.
Swirl Seed had come down. Not going to do it. There is the signaling. Now, usually there's a number in that category, and it might be the first time we're seeing the Draven in mid lane. The LPL here. Kroko, though, he's going to try to call for that Draven onto Tarzan, who is on the wrong side of the tracks now. He is Lilia, though, and has a lot of speed. He's trying to get a little bit of speed up against Kael, but now he's in a lot of trouble. He's going to try to hit Glass Cone into it, and he could get the kill over to Kael here. He's actually going to turn back right. He thought maybe there was an exit strategy, and now he's just proxying the wave. Tarzan's having a lot of fun here. He's trying to make his way out.
He's worn so much time in the process.
Oh my goodness.
He's not making it easy for Kroko to get this kill. And Kael has to stick around because a whole combo, he's just taking more creeps. A whole combo from Tarzan right there could potentially kill Kroko off. But that is so
hard here for Shanks.
He's almost got it. They've spotted Kroko as well on the side right there, trying to clear that brush. And this is the whole part about Lucian. Draven can run you down with Autodax, but Lucian has that burst. When it sticks, it really hurts. Kroko has no flash.
Yeah, there's no way out for Kroko here. He just goes down immediately. What a pounce from Weibo. And now Shanks in a lot of trouble. He has flash, gonna save it for the moment. He's the stand aside, but now Swirlseed hits. He flashes afterwards. He's gonna heal back up though after popping. And we get a little bit more action than maybe we expected in mid lane.
Tried to potentially bait a flash from Shahu right there with his own flash. However, now you're stuck underneath the tower, don't have a lot of HP. You'll see the red buff is on Shahu. He's going to be regening quite a bit. He could be getting dived.
He has the play. He misses, and Shahu beautifully executes him. Oh, bot lane. Crispin low, though, and Hope gets it as well. So there is the trade back in the end. And bot lane stepping up big for anyone's legend.
Oh, this is going to be the battle of the AD carries for sure. But it's not going to be the AD carry in the bot lane for Weibo Gaming. Shahu with a 2-0. As we can see the replay on what happened right there. Overextension by Crisp ended up costing him his life right there. And this is the whole matchup that we're talking about. Whenever you're going up against Braum, you get that initial engage, but a lot of that engage and the damage up front is blocked by the Unbreakable. Therefore, you end up going down because the stun sticks, the slow sticks, and you can very easily proc that.
Oh, Tarzan has six. Kroko, he's in trouble. Might not even need it. Kroko just goes down again. Tarzan gonna be saying you should have stuck to the brand.
Yeah.
Oh, what's up? Hope is stepping up time and time again, but now Light is killer instinct over to him. That's the flash out, and Kael coming over to save the day. The Unbreakable, is it going to be enough? The flash is forward. Tarzan claims the kill in the end. Now Kael in some trouble, but in mid lane, it's Shanks for Shahu, and Shahu sits him down.
Both of these teams have so much to prove in every single lane.
However, it is going to be a 2-for-1 in favor of Weibo.
He's the one that steps up and initiates it, even with it. Still very close.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, we're looking back at it again. It's like deja vu, but Shanks not going to go down. The burn. It's just enough, and Tarzan claims it. And oh my goodness.
Just about, Shanks leaves there. It's not going to be enough, and that Draven pick is not looking that great at the moment, Mazel. Shahu has absolutely dominated that mid lane, lost at level one with Shanks using barriers so aggressively just purely to take control of that lane, and ever since he's lost every single one of those straight.
Yeah, Hope wasn't very pleasantly surprised right there as he lost his entire, half his HP bar, sorry. Riftel is going to be summoned right here knowing that Hope is under pressure in the mid lane, losing a bunch of that HP bar.
The charge is going to come in. You have to commit to killing that Herald before you move in.
They're actually going to try to take out Kael, and then he also got all the damage from Light on top of him. Glacial Fissure in the middle of it, canceled because he just goes down. Another charge in mid lane by the Rift Herald. Meanwhile, you get a 1v1 in topside. Ala in some trouble now. He's trying to run away from all out and breathe. That's lasting damage done by Weibo in mid lane, though.
Great play by Weibo. They knew that AL had to commit to kill that Rift Herald if they wanted to have any sort of pressure into River to try and contest for that dragon.
Meanwhile, you've got pressure from Shahu down the bot lane. You see that Crisp is also around to try and cover for him. Shanks has to wait in a brush, which means not only is he losing all these creeps to the tower, but a lot of that standing gold goes in the pockets of Shahu.
Have woken up a little bit from their rattling against top esports here recently.
I would say that it's not that bad for EL. If there was any other mid laner other than Draven, this is the kind of champion that wants to have pressure and cash in early on. And currently, he's sitting on a 2k gold deficit right there.
Oh, he's gone! The light shines through, and there's no hope left for anyone's legend. There's the whirling death. Is it going to be enough? Get the snipe! And he gets the cash in.
Just about as I was saying, this guy needs to cash in. Oh, wait, there's more.
He's going to be low on those stacks from the deaths, but still, it is a dub nonetheless. Now, Shanks has completed the Lord Dom's after that one, so second item is completed there. A little bit more strength for anyone's legend in the fighting potential now.
Grabs that crit cloak as well. A few crits onto the key targets like Kai'Sa, Lucian, Lilia. Could be very pivotal for a W right here from AEL. Again, Weibo gaming with so much pressure on the map. Light has been playing absolutely out of his mind. Shahu,
what auto attack, by the way. Glacier Fish is going to hit on the double members. Now Tarzan needs to body block a little bit as Kael being very annoying. And Allah gets the deep flank, and Shahu in a lot of trouble now too. He's going to dash to safety. Keeper's verdict, and it's going to be a kill by Allah onto the major member of Shahu, the guy that had all the gold for Weibo.
Great flank from Ale to catch Shahu. He has everything in his pocket. The entire lead is onto him, and AL are looking straight for that Baron. They need to start dodging a lot of these Lilia abilities because there's still a bunch of AoE. Crisp is still there. Does have the ultimate.
This is a heck of a call. If AL want to do this, they're going to turn the fight. They get the wall bang there as well. Ale still tanking up, but there's the Wilting Lullaby coming in. Light still going to be massive. Tarzan getting a lot of damage here too. Breathe all out and back.
Tarzan!
And now Weibo. Look at Tarzan go. Light stepping up as well. All out and breathe. Make the difference. Can Hope stay alive? Hope the only no. It's not enough. Light shuts him down again. And what a mess.
Tarzan goes absolutely crazy. Croco is still around for the Baron.
Oh! He popped him out. Now the Baron's still being taken. I think Weibo, they're going to force this one. Croco, no way into the pit. No smite. And the Baron secured by Weibo.
The second he sees
number three on the table for Weibo, and a lot of strength under tow as well.
Oh, breathe, breathe, breathe.
Caught out. Gotta be careful. It's about the position now. Weibo can collapse. They've got Crisp on the flank. They've got Shahu moving up as well. They might have caught Allah here overextended. He is in trouble now. The rest of the team trying to body block on the other side, but it's not going to be enough. He's completely left out to dry, and this Baron buff is about to get so much work done for Weibo as they crash onto a tier 2 tower in bot side.
Remember, AL love it when Weibo Gaming engage upon them. However, it's a 4 versus 5 Light!
Can't do that. Light has been willing to pull the trigger every time. And it's been a massive difference maker here now as well. Weibo onto the inhib now in bot side. They're trying to take this one down. It looks like they'll pull off afterwards as well. Maybe look to the dragon, as they do need to get a little bit more health under themselves, as they do. It is anyone's legend moving up.
Made AL into walking for that dragon. However, they have so much standing gold in their pockets, translated into items, that right now is the time to fight and take it all. Oh. Together with Croco Zara are going to be probably majority of your damage. Croco hiding in there has to come out eventually, because when you have a tank running at you, you have to forfeit the space. And Weibo Gaming will be taking another free tower.
Oh, Crisp, but there's the killer instinct on top of it. There's the Wombo combo, but not for anyone's legend. They will get one back in the end, but a culling to the back, and that's easily the retreat option for anyone's legend being cut off at the head. They will end up losing Kael as well under turret. And now you've got Ala trying to separate him, but it gets all outed by Breathe, and a triple kill for Light, who is 8-1 on this Kai'Sa, almost going to 9-1 with that one.
Flashes from a W right there for Light. This is a statement game for the Weibo Gaming AD carry. Weibo right here. The death timers are not quite long enough for them to end the game. However, every single inhibitor is going to be dead by the time they're done with AL space.
The man that made miracles happen on LNG. Light has come into question in this split, in this year. Him and Chris. We'll hit on the hope. He's not going to pop it just yet. They're going to try to work on these inhibs as they do.
He does have a flash. He wants to, if he sees him close, he's trying for it.
Ala right there to body block, though, is going to push him back. Now double knockup by Kyle as they get a big Glacial Fissure back. Chris getting low. Nobody going to go down just yet by Weibo. Tarzan wants a big play, but they have to back off. The health bars just aren't there for the damage dealer.
They're overextending a little bit under the Nexus Tower. However, they get the objective they came for, which was at least one of the two last towers remaining for AL. AL absolutely choked underneath the last remaining tower overall.
If they get the Ocean Soul, they can keep sieging. Their health bars are going to be just fine. They can't get caught, though. The dragon goes over. Now Breeze going to go all out, healing up so much. Look at Chris, the three-man magnet storm. And anyone's legend, they're being picked apart here again. Weibo get one back to them, but Ala is going to flash away. The last Nexus turret is still on the horizon. Tarzan getting chunked by Shanks. There's the TP in from Ala as they're trying to save the base. Hope is down. Shanks is down. And Weibo, consistently inconsistent. They'll take game number one against anyone's legend.
These were the best highlights from today's LPL matchup. Click that subscribe button faster than Ramus can say.
Okay.
See you on the next one.